Look at this one. Hey. Is that a fat bass or what? Ooh. Look at that thing. Hey, welcome back to this YouTube exclusive on Xtreme Angler TV. I have a lot of questions about catching those really big largemouth, you know, not the 2 and 3 pound club. Because once you get in the 5, 6 pound, 7 pound club, it's really hard to go back to that 3 pound club. But this is about casting rods. See what I got in my hand right here? Little profile casting reel. You can choose whatever you like, but I use the st.croix. This is one of my most popular ones that I fish with forever. They have different models, but they came out a couple years ago with the pitch and stick 7.5, because 99.9% of the time are those real big largemouth you've seen on Xtreme Angler have been doing this pitching with this heavy, extra heavy casting rods. So no offense to the spinning guys. I know you have caught them, you know, but it's just like a dog, blind dog finding a bone. Happens once in a while. But this is about not by accident. This is about catching big largemouth with big baits, big rods, big lines, big attitudes, just like this first fish I want to show you. Deep beaver house, okay? 15, 20, 25 pitches to the same areas, putting a little soft bait inside there. Once I find those spots that I know potentially hold big fish off the shore, this thing tapered down to about 15 to almost 20 feet of water, all kinds of nasty logs and stuff. Those are the places, the big fat giants you've seen on Xtreme Angler and the ones that you want to catch sit in those spots. Fishing wood, submerged timber. Sometimes it's going to be trees in the water, stumps, and like I was just fishing a beaver dam. But it's late August and the water's cooling and stuff, but that really has no bearing on these largemouth. They're in positions where they should be. They're in docks, trees, you name it. They're in all the spots we like to fish for largies. That's near structure and cover. But today, it's about submerged timber. It's timber time for big, fat largemouth. I'm hoping I'm gonna get some big ones, but it's all about perseverance and fishing in the moment. Let the fish tell me what they want. I'm going to be fishing little pockets, little edges, different things. Wherever there's wood in the water, I'm going to put this little bait, let it sink, shake it, move it, drag it, whatever it takes to get those fish to hopefully bite it. So let's keep going. Let's find some logs. And you can use the same things you see here today on Xtreme Angler on your favorite body of water and catch those big fat hogs sitting on the wood. Let's go. Ooh, it's a huge beaver dam. Comes way out here. Holy moly. Bass could be anywhere here. Anywhere, like out here. Holy moly. That's a huge beaver hole. Come here. Whoa. Whoa. Look at this thing fight, hey? You know why? Because he's big and bad. Oh, where did you get it? He just on the side of the face? Oh, oh no, come here, come here. I can't lift you in, oh, but I can grab you in. That's the ones right there, dudes. When you're fishing beaver dams and stuff, look at the belly on that fish. You think he's eating? Because all kinds of rock bass and nasty stuff go in there, and that's what goes in there too. Big, beautiful, largemouth bass. Look how black their back is. They can hide in that tannic water. They fight like beasts, as you can tell. The wood, don't give up on it, man. Seriously, let's put her in a box. We'll take some pictures. She's got more girth, look at that, seriously, than her length, I bet you. You've been eating good, huh? We'll let you go after, don't worry, big girl. Oh, Lordy. Let's put her in here with her friend. Look at that. Now that's a big, fat bass. But look at that belly. Isn't that impressive? Whew. Let's put her in there. Turn on the pumps. And I tell you, you talk about exciting, man. You know, you find these beaver dams, and what you do is
waypoints, make waypoints. Because you're going up a lake and your focus on where you're driving, you got to be aware of rocks and all that kind of stuff, people, swimming, boaters. And sometimes you miss those little sticks, small beaver dam. But in this case, it must be a big beaver because it comes all the way out here. And I fished. All of a sudden, just feel that familiar sensation. That's all it is. No bite, sensation. Whack! You know what happens then? The world turns off. It's just you and that fish.
Now, I know there's a lot of lakes that you favor to fish largemouth bass, but this comment maybe you won't like. But not all lakes harbor those big, fat, giant largemouth. You know, you might see the odd ones on social media. 4 pounds. Wow, caught a 5-pounder. Wow, how many people did it? It's a known fact. It's all about the DNA, forage, the spawning availability, the seasonal movement of those fish and stuff. If a lot of guys are catching those big bass, you know that that lake harbors big largemouth. How did I do it? I went to the M&R and looked for stocking reports for trout, brook trout, speckled trout, brown trout, where they stocked them, the fingerlings, splake. So I used that as a base on where they put those fish. Okay, so the largemouth was almost king. Yeah, there's muskie there, and there's pike on some of them, but the largemouth, they're king in a lot of those lakes. So they get the best spots, they eat the most food, and they get as fat as possible. Go to your local M&Rs. Remember, this is about Northern Ontario, these fisheries, okay? This is about the northern largemouth, those great big black giants you see. Not all lakes have them. Pick the choices that you see on social media, fish them hard, fish the natural structure. I guarantee you, you put in your legwork, you're gonna catch fish like this next one. Here we go. Look at this. Holy cow, eh? What's the size of him? Is that a big bass or what, hey? What's he got through the nose? Hey, is he hooked good? Let's see. The dog can get him here. Sometimes you gotta reach down like this and get him like that. Look at that, hey? What did I say about going into crazy little spots? Look at the size of him. Is that a giant? Is it? I'd say that's a giant. The big, beautiful fish. Easy, you. Look at the mouth on that thing. That's the kind you can catch when you go to lakes that have largemouth and smallmouth bass and not much weed cover. You find the right stuff, you find these fish. I think this fish is going for a picture, don't you? Oh yeah. He's big, he's bad. He's going in the live well, and he's going to end up on Extreme Angler TV. I love you, big girls. You're so beautiful. Look how big you are. Yeah, you've endured to 3 and 4 pounders. But the emphasis, like I said earlier, go out, try something new, new lakes, new adventures. It'll make you a better fisherman because you'll have to adapt, not just go to the same docks and logs and rocks and all that kind of stuff and weed beds. You try new things, you broaden your horizons. You go out, you have to adapt. You have to try baits that are proven, rodent, jig, craws, different things. You do that, you're gonna catch them just like that. But please, be respectful and let them go after some pictures. Now, one of the best times for those big Ontario largemouth, anywhere near the spawn, forget about it. You say, forget about it. Those fish are biggest, the fattest they are. But we have regulations in Ontario that protect the big largemouth, okay? So unless you have a real early spring, take this as the faith when I'm telling you this. The worst time to look for great big largemouth is just after the season opens, after the spawn. You won't catch the biggest bass of the year after the spawn in Ontario. I don't care about those brown ones. The smallmouth are a whole different creature. I'm talking about those big trophy largemouth. They go into a funk. Trust me when I tell you this, 30 years of doing this, the odd year has been lucky with an early spring. And here's the thing to think about. There's a period where they just go into a funk. Edges and stuff, they hardly eat. I don't care what people say, you know, they scientifically research it and stuff, doesn't matter. I'm in the field, I've seen it, I've done it, I do it for a living. 30 plus years of experience. They go into a funk. After that funk, there's a short window where they go psychotic. They get big, fat, their bellies look like there's a softball in them. You think, man, they haven't spawned yet. They have spawned, but now they're eating everything they can. Bluegills, rock bass, sunfish, perch, crayfish, frogs, you name it. If you're lucky enough to get that, it's usually about, I would say, 10 days to 2 weeks after the season opens. Go to your most favorite spots that time of year or fall. You know why fall is a time of plenty? Lots of fish, less anglers. The best spots, potentially, are all yours. Fish them hard, just like this next fish. Water was high, late September, perfect weather. The fish are putting on the feed bag, and you're there, and there's no one else to bother you. Think to yourself, boy, all summer I've got them deeper, and edges, and weed lines, and crankbait, and everything else. But this time of year, I'm back in stuff like that. Heavy pencil weeds, pads, grass, you name it. The stuff that you think, man, really? Are they in there? Fall? It's a time of plenty, boy. Big fish. Go back in the shallow water to feed. And you got to follow them. Pick your times when you're fishing it. First in the morning, it wouldn't go too shallow. I'd fish maybe 5-6 feet of water. As the sun gets up and gets warmer, get tighter, go closer, skinnier water. Those fish move. They know where they want to be. You know, you get a real cold night and the water, the shallow water, you know, it does get real cold. And sometimes it'll push them out a little bit, but not far, you know. But as soon as it warms up, that peak time, like I said, from about 10, 11 to about 3, 4 o'clock, the sun's high, those fish, you can catch them all day. But the afternoons are peak. Oh my God.
Hold on, boy. Come here. Come here. Oh, here we go. Look where you got it again, folks. Right up through there, huh? Look at that. Right up, way at the back, because the water is higher. Why is that? Because it's been raining a lot. And look at that. On Xtreme Angler, boys and girls, the fall bite. Is it big? Is it fun? You see him jump out of the water? He thinks he's a smallmouth bass. You gonna join your buddy? And we're having a fun day, man. I'm telling you, boy, when it comes together sometimes, you know, the water is so high because a lot of rain. This particular lake's got a lot of creeks and stuff. So it brings in, a couple things happen. Water rises, the temperatures go down, but it doesn't matter. You know what, we're in a fall bite. Those fish, maybe offshore, all that kind of stuff like that, they're now tight again, they want to eat. That fish was so far back that as soon as I hit him, when he turned and stuff, I thought, what is this, a whale? But he's a good one.
Okay, what are the best baits? Jig and chunk, you've seen it for 18 years on Xtreme Angler, man. But some of those fish are not as stupid as they used to be. Now, what does that say about me? Think about it. But no, you still catch them on the jig and chunk everywhere. But sometimes when I'm fishing the more pressured lakes, okay, away from the crowds, I still got a plastic crawfish, beaver style baits, creature baits, but it's always something a bit bigger and bulkier. 5-odd hooks, so big hooks, big line. You see the premise, right? You just keep fishing and fishing. Here's the thing I do too, a lot of times when people talk about cold fronts. I like cold fronts in the middle of summer. You say, man, why? Wear heavier clothes? No, man. You're getting away from a lot of those 2 and 3 pound bites in the best spots. The big ones are in the best spots. Those are the bully bass. So put the baits like the Reaction Innovations, I use like the Blue Craw, I use Green Pumpkin and Watermelon Red. I keep it real basic, but I put these baits in those spots during cold fronts because less small fish, less bites, the bites I do get, remember, I'm looking for 3 to 4 bites a day. This next fish will show you why.
You know what? When I want to go fishing, I go fishing. If it's safe to go, and I'm planning to go, I'm going. I don't care. But this week, on this show, it's about cold front. You know, we had 90-degree weather, beautiful temperature, sun, calm wind, you name it. I decide to go fishing. What happens? Storm goes from 80 degrees to like 45 overnight. Rain showers, thunder showers, you name it. All the excuses in the world not to go fishing and not to catch bass. But you know what? This is why it's called Extreme Angler. I'm going to show you what happens potentially when it's bluebird sky, the clouds are coming in, the rain is still coming. So I got the rain gear in the boat. I'm prepared, but I'm going to have to just dissect. I know the fishing might not be as fast as I want. I will not be throwing a lot of horizontal baits. I'll be pinpointing little dissecting spots, trees, logs, small pad beds, you name it. Anywhere I think those largemouth will tuck up inside and hold because of the storm, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to just vary my routine about where I'm going. You know, shallow stuff, near spawning bays. You know, they spawned about 3 weeks ago, but it's been a late spring in Ontario, so there still could be fish real close to where they spawn. This kind of stuff is what I want to fish. I got a nothing rock face, come to a tree. It's got shade. It's got some logs. And it's going to take today, man, making hundreds of pitches to this kind of stuff, potentially, to get bit. Will it be a big one? I don't know. But as long as I'm getting bit, I'm happy. But when they are there, whoom, they come out. They're not putting a lot of effort in. So I have to put this little bait right into those spots. Spots like this. Look at this. Logs. And right by the shore, it comes down as deep. It's just, you look at it and think, wow, it's really not that deep. It doesn't matter. Look at that. Look at my rod going in the water. See that? And I've never caught a bass. That's, what's that, 24 inches thick? They can be anywhere. Sometimes these overhanging bushes like this and trees and stuff can hold some absolute brutes. When that sun's high, they need somewhere to go for shade. It's not always just the docks, boats, and that kind of stuff. This man-made stuff, it's great. The natural cover, I love it. Set, go. Look at this one. Hey, is that a fat bastard or what? Ooh, look at that thing, huh? That's what I say. Cold front or what? You can still find them and then you can catch them. That makes me happy. Look at that thing. Whew. Now I'm done for the day, folks. Got a good fish, got a few other ones, a lot of peanuts, man. But you put your time and effort in, cold front, who cares? You fish hard, fish smart, and this little bait today, oh man, the little DB craw did what it's supposed to do, helped me catch a couple nice hogs and a bunch of other ones.
Okay, where are those best spots on those lakes that have the big largemouth? Deeper natural structure. Yeah, I've caught a lot of big, fat largemouth on docks, you know, boathouses, floating rafts and stuff. But here's the common theme, that natural structure. Those big ones just know, you know, there's nobody walking on a dock. There's nobody tying up a boat to a boat raft and stuff. There's nobody going into a boathouse. They just know it. It's nature, man. It's like a deer, a wolf, a bear. They just know it. So this right here, I use this 90% of the time. Gamma 20-pound edge fluorocarbon. I don't care if it's muddy. I don't care if it's clear. That's the line that gives me confidence. Think about it. There's no stretch to it. It's one of the strongest fluorocarbons on the market. I change it a lot. But fishing deeper stuff, you can't use the spinning rod. Seriously, it'll break your heart. You might get bit. You might get 1 out of 5, But think about it again. You don't want to catch them by accident. You want to catch these big, fat, largemouth. Heavy rods, fish that stuff. But when you see the good stuff, here's something I'm going to tell you. On the lakes that I've fished for over 25, 30 years, I've narrowed it down to the lakes that have those really big largemouth or the regions that do. Northeastern Ontario, Halliburton, Parry Sound, Bancroft, you name it. Algoma has some fantastic big largemouth opportunities. The thing I do is the same areas all day like this, a milk run, all day long, all day long. I don't go out first in the morning either. It's about 10 o'clock to about 3 o'clock. That's the witching hour for me, 10 to 3 when I get some of the biggest largemouth of my life. I do the milk run. If I'm in an area that has even more spots like that on a lake or adjoining lakes, I'll stay for a couple days and do the other spots. But I don't pressure it, don't fish fast, but I fish the same spots all day long like this, zigzag back and forth, because sometime of the day, that big bad wolf is going to go to those spots and you're going to set it with the heavy action rod and you're going to catch it. Maybe I'll pop a big one on the edge of these pads right here. Ooh, there's a big stump. Get ready, dude. Get ready. Here it comes.
Holy cow. Oh, yeah. Look at this. What a fighter. Look at him. Tell me that's not a beast. Oh my God. Come here, beast. Come here, beast. Oh, I got him. Look at the size of that, dudes. Huh? That little pocket. Look at that mouth. Oh my God, man. I seen this log back there and I said to myself, this or what? That's the proof right there. That's what you see on extreme angle right there. Picking the pockets for bass in Ontario, man. I'm telling you, it gets no better than right here in good old Ontario catching monsters. In for some pictures. I'm going to put those poles down because my heart rate is just going too nuts. And I want to show you this fish. I'm going to put her in the box. Look at this, dudes. Look at the size of that bass. Look at that. Big mouth. Look at the back on her. Just a real big fat beast.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. I hope you subscribe. Hope you follow us on social media. And just think about it. Big fat largemouth get big for a reason. They're not the smartest creatures on earth, but you can catch them if you put in those 5 easy steps. Thanks for watching.